Hi there.
I'm Leeann.
And I'm Michelle.
And together we are
Leeann and Michelle. We love that you're enjoying our funny Enneagram videos.
Yes, thank you so much. Your views, likes, shares, and comments mean the world to us.
And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and click that button.
We've been making these videos for more than a year now, and we love reading your feedback because it really does help us improve.
We read every word, and we try to incorporate your suggestions into our next video.
We thought it would be fun to explain the decisions we make for each type.
Right, but we want to make it clear, we're not Enneagram experts. In fact, we rely a lot on the experts for our content, like our friend Sarah Jane Case over at Enneagram and Coffee.
So the types have become characterizations. Just because what you see in the video doesn't exactly match your type does not mean you're wrong about your type.
But let's get into it, okay? Now, as always, we do have time codes listed in the description, so if you want to go ahead and click forward to your number, go ahead and click on that time code right next to your type. The image I get in my head when I picture an Enneagram 1 is the day planner aisle of any store, like a Michaels or Hobby Lobby or Target. And there's stickers, and there's bookmarks, and there's colored pens. And I think the Enneagram 1 would find that to be a very happy place. I think of Enneagram 1s as very organized and logical people. So things are planned out. They love to check off a to-do list. And they follow the rules. They are rule followers. And they really don't appreciate when other people don't follow the rules. There's guardrails in place for a reason. We need to stay in between them. So when people kind of go off the rails, the Enneagram 1s are like, but why? But why would you do that? The rules are clear and they're not hard. Let's just follow them. Now our videographer Bonnie, who we work with a lot, is an Enneagram 1. So she'll kind of shoot me some ideas as we're shooting on things that she would say or do. And the joke that we have between the two of us is if the camera starts shaking after I say a line because she's laughing, then I know I nailed it for the one. But I have to say, for my characterization, I have in mind as I'm doing my Enneagram 1, one of my best friends, Kristen, who is a kind of typical Enneagram 1. Very organized, runs a tight ship. She has 4 kids, but she's never stressed. She's always just easygoing. She has got everything all organized. It's all fine. She has a lot of balls in the air. She can do a lot of things at once. And she really gets annoyed when people don't follow the rules or they want to infringe on her rights or something like that. So that's who I kind of have in mind as my friend Kristen when I'm characterizing the one. You awesome, organized rule followers.
First of all, I just have to say that I really, truly, in my heart, believe that the world would just fall apart. It would disintegrate without twos. I am envious, and I know that is my 4 talking envy, but I am so envious of the way that twos just naturally think outside of themselves, what a gift that is to their communities and to their families. So this is how I play the Enneagram 2. She sounds a lot like this. She's never not smiling. I mean, there's very few moments where she lets her guard down. So I had a childhood pastor and his wife. Her name was Sue Forseth, and I loved her. And I think for some reason, I don't know if she was 2 or not, but I think that was initially where the inspiration came from. And now I think she's just an amalgam of Sue and all the other marvelous 2s in my life that I love, most of whom are not from the Midwest. But those types of character choices, like a dialect or some gesture with your hands, that's just really helpful, I think, for our viewers to separate the types that they're seeing over and over again, just to distinguish them from one another. My version of the Enneagram 2 is always standing at your door with a steaming hot casserole. I mean, she just is. And in the earlier videos, somebody once commented, why is it always food? Not all 2s are obsessed with food. But I'm someone who's not a good cook. So I think when someone makes me a meal, it just like means so much to me. So I think that's why initially all of her love tokens were food. I definitely know that the ways that Enneagram 2s express their love is more varied than that. But I think that's probably the reason for me. It's always like, food! She's showing up with food. Food is love to me.
Here's the deal with 3s. Nothing in this world would ever get done if it weren't for threes. Nothing would ever get started nor completed if threes didn't exist. Threes are crazy important. An Enneagram 3 is a boss. So they have an idea, they can see it through to completion, and they want you to know that they did that. They want the recognition. They appreciate the pat on the back and the gold plaque. They want that stuff. They want the likes on Instagram. They want that to show up. And that's a major part of the threes, is making sure that they're recognized. And I think that's why I got a little distracted when we first started doing these videos, and that's what I was focused on. And my character that I had in my mind at that point was this Instagram influencer who had a flower crown in her hair, and she had macrame curtains that she put together herself, and she sold them on Etsy. And she's very like Alexis from Schitt's Creek. Ew. And that's evolved now because I realized that not all threes are that obsessed with aesthetics. And so that's evolved now and has kind of taken that character, and you know, now she's the CEO of her company. I'm an Enneagram 8, and I really do think we have a lot in common with threes, and I can relate to that. And as I study this more and do more and more of these videos, I'm realizing how much I love threes and how much I love portraying them, because there is a part of me that really can relate to the threes. And I have a lot of friends that are threes who are all entrepreneurs or business owners. And my friends who own businesses that are not threes want to hire threes because threes get stuff done. They just do. They just do. They get it done with a flower crown in their hair. And you better give them some Instagram love. Like.
Let's talk about four, baby. Let's talk about crazy me. I love my fourness now that I know I'm a four. As soon as I understood that, like, there are others like you out there, I was like, oh, that makes life so much easier. For me, reading oh, there's a bird. Legitimately, I know I do this in all my videos. There is a magnificent wren hopping along the garden. There really was. I wish you could flip the camera around. It had a black back and a brown chest. It was really beautiful. My character gets distracted by birds in almost every video. There's a reason for that. So my four is, I would say I have a high need in my life for beauty and order. Whatever that means to you individually, that's like a thing that four shares. It has to be beautiful to them. My characterization of the four is very particular about her environment. The idea of beauty over function is an ongoing in my house, because I just want it to be beautiful. She is very self-involved, as a lot of fours tend to be before they start working on themselves. She's just very into what she's experiencing and making sure she's saying it in the perfect way. Highly values her uniqueness, definitely wants people to see it. And the interesting thing about the four is, I think initially it was the hardest character to play, because the things that she does, that very indulgent way of explaining everything, and those are things I try not to do as much. Her long-winded way of explaining everything, which I realize I'm totally doing right now. I'm doing it. I'm being her. So the four is me stretched out in some new comical directions, but I am my own inspiration for the four. I am four. I got a five wing. I do. And that comes out in my like manic love of documentaries, my strong skew toward minimalism, and my internal, the way that I think that I'll never be ready to do the next thing. Like, I feel like I've never mastered something enough to really put it out there, saying, let me think about that and get back to you. I say this a lot to Michelle. She'll be like, just throw some ideas out at me. Just like, give me some. And I'm like, oh, I don't have any good ideas. And then I'll rattle off like a couple of ideas that I work on. And I'm like, but they're still not good enough. And Michelle will be like, those are great. Let's use them. So that's where I see my five wing the loudest. My desire to incubate an idea and perfect and master it before I let it loose. my need for quiet, and my high levels of introversion. I'm not going to say that quarantine has been a delight, but I don't hate it. As far as the five's actual like character choice, I choose to keep her very monotone and very flat, and she speaks very quickly because a lot of the fives in my life are just full of information, and it's like you just push their trigger button, like you just say the topic, like minimalism, and all of this wealth of information just comes pouring out at them because they've been backlogging it for months and months and months and months and months. And no, they're not an expert, but they'd like to tell you what they know. I wanted to separate her from the other types by giving her a different cadence, a different speech pattern. So that was where that came from. And also the fact that myself and a lot of the other fives I know, we do this thing. We hoard our information, and then someone pushes our trigger button, and we just give you the torrent of knowledge that you didn't know you needed.
Six, man, you guys, this is the hardest one for me to act out, the six. And I think it's because it's the hardest one for me to understand. It's been a struggle for me. I researched the sixes so much before we do videos because I think I'm still struggling to get my head around it. And I know that I rely a lot on the kind of crutch of a joke of worst case scenario, doomsday thinking, planning for the worst, you know where all the exits are. But that's the funny part of sixes. And I think that if sixes are willing to laugh at themselves, not all of you are, that's okay. But if they're willing to laugh at themselves, those are the kinds of things that we realize are ridiculous. Like the fact that they read every single Yelp review of a restaurant before they go there. They want to look at the menu and plan out what they want to eat. But my sixth character is, she's a little like, not like I told you so, but she's a little bit like she knows what's going on. She knows. And I do feel like sixes know more than we think they do. And they know more than they want us to think that we know. If that makes sense. They know a lot. And they share it when they want to. They don't just share everything at once, but they will share stuff when they want to. And then when they really want to, they will overshare. So that's my girl. She's a little bit reserved when she's presenting information, but then if it's a topic she's pretty passionate about, she will unload and she will let you know. And that gets her into trouble sometimes. And that's where we see some of the comedy come out. But I do know one thing for a fact. If we didn't have sixes, a lot of bad things would happen to the rest of us. So sixes protect us, and they're the superhero of the Enneagram. That's what I think about sixes. They need capes.
I love playing the seven the best. I know we're not supposed to pick favorites. If you could pick your type, if you were allowed to pick your type, I think I would choose to be a seven. I love people who say yes, and I feel like seven's default mechanism is just, yep, mm-hmm, I'll try it, I'll do it, I'll eat it, I'll climb it, I'll wear it, I'll whatever. And I just find that so appealing. I love people who live their lives that way. But as far as like the characters I get to play in these videos, the seven is, she's absolutely my baby favorite. She's a real grip it and rip it kind of girl. I love it no matter what absurd thought comes into my head, my seven character gets to try it. So one of my best friends who is a seven asked me why I make my seven talk like a dude, which I take issue with because females are allowed to have husky voices. This is 2020. We can sound however we want. I was maybe a little bit inspired by Melissa McCarthy in Bridesmaids. I love what she does with her voice in that movie. And then I added that little bit of vocal fray in moments. And just a little more mania. And there you have it, a seven. Oh, I love sevens. I do, I love them.
I am an Enneagram 8. I'm an Enneagram 8 wing seven, and eights are my favorite to play. Obviously I can relate to eights because I'm an eight, and that makes it really fun so I can pull from my own experiences. Why is my light not turning on? My light not turning on right now? It's a very Enneagram 8 moment. I'm not happy about it. Come on. Oh God, I don't have to murder the light now. The eights are big characters. Big characters. There's a lot to pull from. So obviously I've been an 8 my whole life. I didn't understand the Enneagram until the last couple of years. And I know that I'm healthy now, and I have been a healthy 8 for a while, but I wasn't always healthy. And a lot of the unhealthy Michelle from a few years back is what I pull from for this character. So it is me, but it's definitely amplified, and it's definitely a more negative version of me that I use. The impatience and the annoyance and all that kind of stuff is fun to make comedy out of. And so that's what I tend to rely on a lot with the 8s, is kind of this leaning into kind of their negative side and making it funnier. My 8 character is a workaholic. She does a lot of things, so she's always juggling a lot of balls. Sometimes she does it well, sometimes she doesn't. 8s tend to make decisions really fast. I would rather make a decision that turns out to be the wrong decision than sit there and overanalyze a decision that needs to be made. We work fast. My family jokes with me, I'm always the first one done with dinner because there are other things to do. Like, get this done, get this out of the way. Let's move on to the next thing we gotta get done. One of my favorite moments in our videos is our Walt Disney World video in the Enneagram 8 section, where I'm kind of racing through the crowd to get to the next thing, and people are walking slow, and I'm like, walk as you drive, come on, it's not that hard, walk as you drive. And that's always going on in my mind when I'm walking through a crowd. Every time. I feel like that is pinnacle 8-ness right there.
Not all 9s are introverted, but a lot of them tend to skew that way. They love escaping into a good nap or diversion and procrastination, which I am all for. And also the high need for the opposite of conflict. That's the hallmark of the 9. You are at enmity with enmity. It was very 4 of me to say enmity where conflict would have done, but enmity is a way more dramatic word. So my favorite thing about 9s is their desire for peace, which is just at its core. And when a person is healthy, that is like such a pure and beautiful thing. Quietly stubborn, secretly very opinionated. Those still waters running so deep. I love that 9s sort of intuitively meet people's needs, and generally they don't really want, or if they, maybe they don't want, it's not that they don't want the credit, they don't take the credit for it. Maybe they do want the credit sometimes and they wish people would just give them the credit without having to ask for the credit, because asking for credit would be confrontational. I love 9s. I see her in general as being deferential to the people around her, but I had to separate her from the 2. Initially, I think I played her very close to the 2, and that obviously wasn't going to work. And so what I ended up doing was swallowing up her voice just a little bit. She smiles, but she's smiling through the pain. She doesn't want to be too loud because that's counter to what she's practiced her whole life, which is don't take up too much space with your ideas and your opinions. She's almost apologizing for talking. It's like a whisper shout. There is nothing like a healthy 9 to just bring harmony to situations. Hopefully that helps you all understand our characterizations of the Enneagram types.
And as always, we really appreciate your feedback. So go ahead and leave a comment below and let us know what we got right, what we can do better, and don't forget to tell us your type.
Thanks for watching. I'm Leeann.
And I'm Michelle. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button so we can... Leeann, I'm still talking.
When I don't know what
I'm still talking. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button so we can...
Please love me.
Give you more Enneagram funny content.
Felt like a newscaster. Thanks for watching, America. Thanks for watching. I'm really glad no one's in this room right now.